And to say yes. Hello and welcome once again to Mystery Beer Books. It's always a great opportunity and a pleasure for Louis and I to share with you some of the books that we have here in Mystery Beer. Today we both decided to concentrate on a writer who is literally one of my favorite authors, probably my very favorite author, and that is George Orwell. George Orwell, born Eric Arthur Blair, is a writer of profound importance internationally. As a writer, Orwell produced literary criticism and poetry and fiction and polemical journalism. And he's best known, of course, for his allegorical novel, Alamo Farm, which is world famous. And also, of course, for this, his dystopian novel, 1984, which is responsible today, of course, for some of the most popular words in the English language. The Thought Police, Big Brother, well, there are so many of them. Room 101, all of these things he wrote. Trolls, Unperson, Thought Police, so many. But anyway, this is a profoundly important book. He then wrote The Road to Wigan Pier, which was very, very interesting. The Road to Wigan Pier. It documented the experiences, his experience actually, of working class life in north of England. Then Homage to Catalonia was an account of George Orwell's experiences soldiering for the Republican faction of the Spanish Civil War. And then he's got all these essays, Such Were the Joys, which were really, really cool, essays on a variety of subjects, politics, literature, language, and culture. Then we have The English People, his thoughts on the English people. It was, you know, the Times of London ranked George Orwell as one of the second of the 50 most important writers, contemporary writers, of the English language. Is a brilliant, brilliant writer. One of my very favorite books of all time is George Orwell's Keep the Aspidistra Flying, which is about a poet called Gordon Comstock in London in 1934, the archetypical starving poet. And the poet decides that there is no longer such a thing as good and evil. In the contemporary world, it's rich and poor, that's it. If you're rich, you're considered good. If you're poor, you're considered evil. And so this character, Gordon Comstock, decides that he's going to try and live in a world without the money god. And he fails every step of the way. Money defeats him every step of the way. It's a brilliant, brilliant book. So I would encourage anybody who has any interest in discovering George Orwell to pick up one of his books, any one of them. And I think that you'll find it an enlightening and an entertaining experience. He died prematurely, died in Scotland actually, of lung disease. But anyway, thank you once again for giving us the opportunity to share this with you. And please come in and visit Mystery Beer Books. It will be, as it always is, a very great pleasure. Thanks for listening.